points of the needles. Now, take into account, let's say, for example, a points of the needle. If you can see, one of the point is a tapering point. One of the point to understand is a tapering point. Now, what exactly is this? Tapering in the sense, it is like this. It is gradually increasing in the diameter of the point. If you can, this is what is the point. If you can see, circular. Can you see that here? And it is gradually increasing to become the body ka size by, let's say, 2 to 3 millimeter. 2 to 3 millimeter, gradually increasing. And body can be quadrangular or can be circular, let's say, for example. So agar tapering point hai, circular wala, and it is gradually increasing to the body ka diameter in about 2 to 3 millimeters of the length of the needle, this is what is called as a tapering point. Usually it is atraumatic ones. This is what is also called as a round body. You must have heard about round body needle. Round body needle. Now, what exactly is round body? Round body needle has got a circular tip. Now, it is not that much traumatic. It is not. It has atraumatic ones. It is usually used for internal organs and a thick mucosa. Internal organs. If you want to suture, let's say, for example, bowels, spleen, uterus, you are going to use a round body needle because I don't want tissues to get damaged more. It is going to go through the organ smoothly and it's going to come out. But suturing is very hard if it is a tough tissue. Try to suture it, the rectus sheath, let's say, for example, or a skin with a round body, it is very tough. You need to use a different tip because skin is a very tough structure. Rectus sheath is a very tough structure. Or I can also say the other tough structure you must know of is a periosteum. Or I can also say scalp. All are very tough structures. It is not possible to go through these mentioned areas of the body with a round body needle. It is not possible. It's very tough. So we need to use a different needles. Lekin ye wala jo hai, ye needle is used for internal organs and a thin mucosa. But suturing is very hard in case of tough tissues. Let me also go through a different point of the needle. If you can see, there's a cutting points. Now let's say, if you take the cross section of this, it is triangular tip. It is not round. The cutting edge on the inside of the circle, if you can see, the tip has got a triangular shape that is given to the tip. Because of the triangular shape, it is going to go through tough structures very easily. In fact, when you go to the tailor, and I was talking about your jeans is getting stitched, he uses a triangular needle like this. A needle which has got triangular tip, also called a cutting tip. Cutting edge on the inside of the circle. It is used for skin, all those locations we talked about, rectus sheath, periosteum. I use a traumatic, or I can say, triangular tip needle. Now this triangular can be like this, or triangle can also be like this. I'm going to reverse cutting, it is called as. I'm going to come to it. This is what is a regular cutting. And we also have a reverse cutting. This triangle is in opposite direction. Now, my question is, if you use it for internal organs, what will happen? Internal organs are very soft. If you use it, the break you're going to create in the internal organs will be bigger than the size of the needle, and it is going to bleed very heavily. So do not use it. Even if you are best surgeon, but if you use a wrong needle, you had it, then it is not very easy for the surgeon to control the bleeding. So again, let me repeat, there is a cutting edge on the tip, that is the cutting, cutting edge on the inside of the circle. We use it for tough structures called as skin, rectus sheath, periosteum, scalp. Try to suture scalp with a round body needle. You will require a hammer for the needle to go inside. Of course, we don't do it. We use a tapering cut or maybe cutting body needle. This is what is called a conventional cutting. We also have a reverse cutting like this. Let me also have it. Same. Consider reverse cutting. We also have the reverse cutting. The cutting edge of the inside of the circle, again we use it for skin, less traumatic than cutting, but we have a reverse cutting needle. The triangle is ulta. Now what is the difference? Let me show it to you. Because this type and the previous one type, what exactly is the difference? If it is given, yes. What exactly is the, if you can see, yes. Conventional cutting has got tip like this. So sharp edge is here. And if you pull over, it can also tear this one. If you can see, can you see that? Can also tear because this also has got a sharp edge here. Not only at the tip, the sharp edge is also here. So if it is, if you are going to pull it very hard, use reverse cutting. Ye wala. Because isme sharp edge niche hai. The sharp edge is downwards. So that even if you pull it, it is not going to pull over. It is not going to tear. Again, not many books have given this. This is going to be very important. This is going to be very important. A conventional cutting and a reverse cutting. Let me repeat. Conventional cutting has got the sharp edge where you are going to pull. So if you pull before the needle being taken out, you are going to tear the structure. So if it is possibility of pulling over the structure, let's say for example we have a rectus sheath, we always pull it very tightly. So always use a reverse cutting for rectus sheath. You can also use, but don't pull before you take out the needle, otherwise the rectus sheath is going to get teared off. Rectus sheath is going to get teared off. It's going to be very important point. Not many books has mentioned this, but at least we can be able to understand it. I hope it will be understood properly. As I was talking about, we also have different shapes of the needles. Different shapes of the needle. If you can see properly, depending upon the circle, kidna circle hai. Let's say for example, we have a 3/8 of the circle. This is what is the 3/8 of the circle. 1/2 of the circle. A straight. Do we have a place for straight needle these days for surgeries? Straight needles are used for subcuticular stitches. This slide has got, because it takes a beautiful subcuticular stitches where you don't see the suture marks, scars on the body. The suture is running under the skin. And for subcuticular is for skin. Subcuticular is for the skin. And we also have some speciality needles like a J-shaped needle and all those things. Very rarely we use it. But more commonly we have 3/8 of the circle, half of the circle. Somebody will say, what difference does it make? Now remember, if you have a 3